in place beforehand. There's been a lot of preparation. And now we wait. This is such a slow-moving storm. Everyone's just been watching it for days.
Yeah, anticipation rises, yeah. And you're just every single day. I mean, there could be a change yesterday. Oh, it's not going to be here.
The track has just been shifting. Everyone's watching. Where is it going
to
go?
So the best thing is to be prepared, as you mentioned.
Exactly.
Yeah. So we'll look at the satellite radar right now. There's Hurricane Dorian right there. The cloud coverage. You can see the bands of rain from the south all the way to the north. This is just a gigantic hurricane. It's moving very slowly to the west. This is a loop over the last 6 hours, and it hasn't traveled very far, and it will continue at this slow pace as we go into this evening and into the overnight hours there for those folks on the eastern coast. Okay, so here's the track that it's looking like it could potentially take, and of course it could veer off to the west a little bit or a little bit further off to the east, and it's still expected to be a category 5 hurricane for some time. Wind about 185 miles per hour there at some of the strongest locations, and gusting to about 220. Very, very strong. A lot of warm water to fuel this hurricane as it does still travel over the next day or two, and then that will eventually continue and hopefully push off to the east. Best case scenario, it kicks out of here and we're not going to be dealing with it. Now, this isn't Dorian right here, but this is a good example of what it looks like there at the eye and the eye wall. Now, over the last few years, there's been a handful of Category 5 hurricanes. We have Dorian right now. We have Michael from last year. 2017, we had two. And then 2016, we had Hurricane Matthew. So it's been very busy for the Atlantic Basin over the last few years. How about here locally? We do have really, really splendid weather, and it's going to continue as we go through our Sunday evening and then into our Monday. Tomorrow and Tuesday, slightly warmer, and that goes for Wednesday, but then we have a chance to cool down by the time we reach next weekend, taking our temperatures from the mid-80s down to probably the upper 70s, which might feel nice for a few people. Okay, we have 80 out of Vancouver right now, 84 out of PDX. This will be the third day in a row that we hit 84. 66 coming out of Astoria and Newport, a pair of sixes there. This evening, temperatures cooling down to the upper 70s, a few clouds clearing out. Again, pretty mild through the overnight hours. Gentle breeze right now, the northwest. It goes out of the west for the coast there, but it does pick up an intensity for areas like Government Camp and over towards the Dalles and Madras, where those temperatures are also a bit warmer in the upper 80s to about 90. Okay, a disturbance to the northwest will keep clouds of rain over towards Vancouver Island, dry here through Oregon. It will stay that way as we go into this evening. Just a beautiful scene coming out of Stoller Winery right now. Your Labor Day forecast, if you want to take a look at that, from the coast to the valley to the gorge, by midday into the 70s, we'll top off there in the lower 80s. Great day to be with friends and family as we go through a few hours here. Yeah, not much occurring heading into Monday morning. So if you have a barbecue planned, get out there and enjoy it. 7 day forecast here, 85 Tuesday, 86 Wednesday. Those will be the warmest days this week. And then we cool down to the upper 70s Saturday and Sunday.
I mean, it's looking pretty good. My parents were a little frustrated when I showed them our 7 day forecast because they're near Orlando right now. Yeah. So yeah, their weather not looking so great.
We'll be thinking about them.
Yeah, mom's trying not to get into the hurricane snacks right now, so she's okay.
You gotta store those.
Exactly. Yeah. Thanks, Joseph. Mm-hmm. All right, coming up next.